Hi everyone! Today we are demoing Queen's Library's mobile tablet app. In this demo, we will be showcasing components of our mobile discovery and delivery platform developed for our evolving virtual library initiative. Right now, the tablet mobile discovery and delivery is exclusively offered as a curated experience for tablet loaning programs, although it shares some cool features with Queen's Library's mobile application. I'll highlight how to find out more about all that at the end of the demo. Okay, let's get started. As you can see here, I've already launched the Queen's Library tablet app on my Queen's Library issue tablet. I've also had a little walkthrough with a library specialist, and I've reviewed my enclosed help documents. I have my credentials ready to go, so I'm going to go ahead and log in. I accept the terms and conditions because I must accept the terms to continue, so I scroll down to the bottom and I tap agree. Okay, I'm in, and I'm presented with a simple menu system. Let's tap around a bit. First, I'll go to Discover. Discover is where we house all of our curated content for our patrons. Let's go to Kids. Here you see highlighted books, programs, and the ability to explore more by age. Let's go back out. And now we'll go to Teens. Again, you see the highlighted books, programs, and now there's the ability to explore more with web links and databases that would be of interest to our teen patrons. Let's look at hours and locations. Here's a list of all of our locations, their hours of operation, their addresses, and their phone numbers. On the right-hand side, you'll see a shortcut menu that allows us to navigate throughout the app without ever having to go back to the home screen. For example, if I click on the calendar, I go to Programs. Here's a list of all of our programs. You can click into each program to see more, like Introduction to Computers. If there was more locations or dates, you'd see it below, and there's the ability to register right from here. Let's go to the internet now. If you tap on the globe, you'll get to the internet browser. The web traffic goes through our proxy filtering, since we view the tablets as an extension of the library. So this software complies with our SIPA standards and applied rules for patron types and age groups. Let's see, let's go to nyc.gov and maybe learn some details of upcoming cultural events. See, pretty easy, and once you close this window, it brings you right back to the mobile app. All right, now I'm going to tap around. There's above my library, the little heart, gives you the details to become a friend of the library, volunteer at the library, or even donate. In my account, there's the ability to see your checked out items, get to your downloads. Like if I wanted to look at my checked out items right now, I would tap on checked out. And I would have a full list, including the due date, how many times it was renewed. And if I want to renew something right now, I would just tap on it and click renew. And I'd be told that it was renewed successfully, and the due date would be updated. Now let's get to the fun stuff and go to eBooks. I'm going to go to Access 360 and see what they have to offer today. These simple genre listings make for quick decisions. Let's go with this book here. I'm going to use the drop down to select the Biblio format and click download. That's going to allow me to download authenticate, and check out all in one action, which simplifies my life tremendously. Okay, I'm going to enter in my Blio password and click OK. I have to wait a little bit for the download to complete before I can jump over to the Blio Reader, which I downloaded separately. I'll click Yes and read it now to make sure everything is in order. Tap Download and then Open. Okay, I'm going to go back up by tapping the back button on the device to browse a bit more. Let's see if there's anything else to download later. This one looks interesting. I'll be sure to check this one out this evening. But now I'm going to head over to the Zinio eMagazine titles. Just tap on Zinio. I can't believe all of this is in here. Let's take a look at something in the recent list. I'll go with this one. And now I'm going to tap download. Before I jump over to the Zinio app, which is an integrated yet separate experience to read my magazine, I have the choice to continue to browse around here in the QL app. But let's go ahead and dive into Read Now. So I'll tap Yes. I've previously logged into the Zinio app, so I can now seamlessly jump between the two apps, and I will be reading in moments without paying any newsstand or online fees. To get to your magazine list, you tap the open book in the top right-hand corner, and then you see your list of magazines. So you see the new magazine is downloading. It might take a while, so let's take a look at a title I've previously downloaded while this one is finishing up. As you can see, you can quickly go from boredom to reading in just a few intuitive clicks. Let's check back on our other download. It looks like I can start reading as the rest of the pages stream in the background. This is awesome. For those of you that want to learn more, please contact Kelvin Watson at Queen's Library, 718-990-0753 for more information. He can also be reached at kwatson@queenslibrary.org. Thank you, and this completes our quick demo.